Hey, cowboy.
Any memories coming back yet?
Not so far, but something tells me I might be missing out on some really good ones.
That's solid detective work.
So, were we dating?
Dating? Oh, that's so cute. I guess you can call it that. But we were also working together in a more professional capacity.
Well, now my detective skills are picking up a little sarcasm.
Seriously, cowboy. You're good. I've learned a lot working with you the past couple weeks.
Let me get this straight. You and I were working on a case together? Do you mind telling me about that?
Not at all. You wanted a list of tenants here at the Ritz as far back as I could go.
Why would I do that?
It was your dreams. They were vivid before, but they were getting out of control. It's almost like they were changing you into someone else. You talked about seeing things from the past, but you wouldn't give me details. You were incredibly stressed. It was like you actually believed this apartment was haunted. You even started looking into psychometry.
Psycho what?
Psychometry. It's the belief that an object can contain a person's energy.
So, not only am I an amnesiac, but I'm a paranormal idiot. Great.
Sounds crazy, I know. But then we found out about Donnelly.
Who?
JT Donnelly. It was the most bizarre thing. I'd heard you mention the name in your sleep. But then, his name turned up when I checked out the previous tenants.
So who is this guy?
He's a private investigator. A real old school brute. He worked for some powerful, influential people. But then he disappeared around 1943. His last known address was here.
San Francisco?
No, here, at the Ritz in this exact apartment.
Okay, that's a little bizarre.
It gets bizarrier. You called me one night, raving like a lunatic, saying the walls were talking. I rushed over and found a hole smashed in the wall, and you curled up on the floor in a ball.
Well, I'm glad to hear I haven't changed that much.
You wouldn't tell me what had happened. But after that, you wouldn't sleep here. That's when you got your new place and started to sleep there.
Hold on. I have another place?
Yes, you do. And it's even nicer than here.
This is all crazy. I think I'm gonna sleep here tonight just to see whether it affects me in the same way.
Do you want some company?
Listen. Taylor, I'm beginning to see what the other me saw in you. But in my head, it's still 2043. I've got to tell you, there was somebody else.
Chelsea, I know. I know how much she meant to you, Tex. Losing her was traumatic as hell for you. But she's gone. And there's nothing you can say or do or don't do that's going to bring her back.
I sure do.
I'm alive. And that's my heart. It's yours if you want it. And it comes with all the other bits.
I'm sorry, Taylor, but I love Chelsea. And I never even got the chance to tell her. And if there's any chance that I can find her, I've got to do it. I hope you'd understand.
I don't understand, Tex. Why can't you let this go? It's crazy. That room you have across the hall with all our stuff is like some sick Chelsea shrine. I'm sorry I shouldn't have said that.